But not from our school. We are, if not giving have this feeling of enjoying by our tongue, by our mouth. We say this prasad very good, very good, very good. Why? Very good in the sense of my enjoyment. Very good means it is not in the sense of the enjoyment of Lord Krishna. We do not know whether God has tested the good will or not. So, is there any shortage of very delicious food in his house? Are not the devotees of our need? Do not the devotees of our need take us today? Duryodhana wanted to see Krishna with his dark, the dishes of being of king. But Krishna did not come in, came towards that. He went to the house of Vidur and accepted the rice, which is of broken rice. But why? Why he accepted that rice? Vidur was the devotee sincere. He loved Krishna sincerely. But Duryodhana had no sincerity of love, so he did not accept the offer. Patram Kuspam Phalam Kuyam Yumi Bhakta Sadaha Bhakti Parintam Asnami Vrajatatmanaha Vrajatatmanaha. See, who has controlling that hand, mind, body, etc. must be controlled. We must not let it go freely as it like. So, very good. But the enjoyment we have had in Mathura Vrindavan, because there are delicious food, delicious songs, sweet melody, etc. That is not the true meaning, successful meaning. But we must try to always try to give up my fasting. First, give up my spirit of enjoyment and try to secure the devoting spirit. We should devote our everything which we possess. So, body, mind, soul, money, anything. Consider what sort of devotion we have made for Krishna. Whatever we are doing for our own gratification of senses is not true. Certainly. We do not know how Krishna may be satisfied. We do not know. Because it is beyond our senses. So how can we know? By the guidance of, by listening, by following the advice of Divine Master, we can understand that this is the, by this way, Krishna may be satisfied. So devotional function will be successful when we shall give up the enjoying this path. We shall know Siddha Pratu Sattva Sattva. Then, by getting with the company of the devotee and Divine Master and by the grace of Lord Krishna and Paramatma, we may attain that devotional spirit. That devotional spirit is the only object for which we should gather. That's a bunch of questions.
अंग श्याम छटा फिर मंदिर तेंदुला जगन जागरोच संगदर्शन पथंगरश वृंदारण निवासिनम सत्रामाभिरामोदर राधास्कंद निवेशितो जलभुजं ध्यायामि तवैवास्मि जीवामृतया विना तिरिन्द्राय राधे तं नमामि। कृष्ण इस ओम वर्षिक है एंड ही इज ओशन ऑफ अर्श। इन कृष्ण लीला ही कुड नॉट बी सेटिस्फाइड एंड दैट इज वाई हिज थ्री एम्बिशंस वेर नॉट फुलफिल्ड। He took the beauty, golden beauty of Radhika and inner mood of Radhika and he appeared in this Kali as Sachinandan Gaurhari. In childhood, he did so many sweet pastimes in Navadvipa. And after that, he was married two marriages. And after that, he went to Gaya. And he was associated with Ishwar Puripad. And he took shelter in the lotus feet of Ishwar Puripad. And he was initiated there. At once he was changed and then he was running towards Vrindavan. Oh, where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? Anyhow, he returned. So, Navadvipa. But his life was changed too. Always doing kirtan. He stopped his teaching to Sanskrit, to Vyakaran, to others. And he began to Nagar Sankirtan and Sankirtan always. After some time, he left Vishnupriya also. Took sannyas, renounce order, and went to Puri. And there, from there he went to South India, met with Raya Ramananda. And he told Raya Ramananda that you should come with me. And he agreed. He left his service and joined his mission. He also came in Puri. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu first, he was taking part in Rath festival and so many things were done. You know, Pratap Rudra Raja and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu relations and what happened there. After 24 years, he totally was changed. No Nagar Sankirtan, nothing. Always in Gambhira, weeping for Krishna. Oh, Krishna, where you are? And all these symptoms of highest love and affection, also Ashtashakti Vikar, Anubhav, Vyabhichari Bhav, all were seen in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Anyone has never seen anywhere else. Only it was written something in Shastra. Even Sarvam Bhattacharya, so learned, but he could not realize him. He thought that he is only high class of Vaishnava, Bhagavata. But he could not recognize him. Though Gopinath Acharya insisted him and told him very strongly that he is Krishna himself. But he could not believe. At last, he wanted to teach Chaitanya Mahaprabhu something. And after 7 days classes, he was changed and he became a pure devotee. He saw this 600 form of Krishna, Ramachandra and Mahaprabhu. And then he became pure. Then he realized that how high class of Mahabhagavata is Rayaramani. So he requested that if you are going to South India, meet with him. So he went there and meet, and he knew Ramananda Sambhar. And after Ramananda also left everything and he came. Now Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, testing that three modes, which were Malli in Srimati Radha. Mahabhav, Rudhubhav, Adhirudhubhav. More than this, which is only in the Swarup, constitutional things in Srimati Radhika, that is Madan, Modan and after that, everything. Only two persons, Raya Ramananda and Swarup Damodar, used to be with him, consoling him. Always weeping, sometimes falling down in the sea, oh, Krishna is here, playing with the gopis. Sometimes in Jagannath Bagh, the garden of Jagannath. Sometimes in the front of Jagannath temple. Sometimes so long, sometimes like a round figure. So, very, very strange thing. At that time, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami has written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, in last of Chaitanya Charitamrita, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. In that stage, he composed only 8 verses. In that stage, not in first stage, last stage, when he is weeping so bitterly, oh Krishna, I am dying without you. Last stage of praying, Mahabhava. And at that time, he was discussing all these things in weeping mode to Raya Ramananda and Swarup Damodar. Govinda, the shavak of his Gurudev, was there. And he was complaining to Raya Ramananda Swarup Damodar, why you come in night here? You should not come. By seeing you, he weeps more bitterly. You should not come. You should try to console him, but when you come, oh, he weeps so much. Sometimes he becomes faint. So, this Shikshastra is so important. From beginning of sadhana bhajan, and even in prayojan, Krishna prem is there. Sambandha, avidhi and prayojan. In this Shikshastra, you can imagine that how supreme teachings are the 8 Shikshas, 8 slokas of Shikshastra. that he used to discuss with Raya Ramananda and Sarup Damodar. And weeping. So it is so high class. But it is from beginning to end. Everything is in this sloka. Everything. Sambandha, avidhya, prayojan, everything. What is sambandha? What is the relation with Krishna to all the jivas? We are part parcel of Krishna. We are eternal servant of Krishna. All jivas, grasses, trees, everything. Yes. But we are not realizing. Pujya Patrabhika Maharaj told so many things. You can see that, oh, he is very rough, telling so many things. But actually he is so merciful that he is telling. Really, we don't realize his teachings, but real thing is there. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is telling all these things. Cheto darpana marjanam bhav maha davagne nirvapam shreya kairav chandrika vitaram vidya vadhu jivan anandam bodhi pardham pratipadam purnam tasvadam sarvatma smadam param vijayate krishna Srila Bhakti Satchitananda Bhakti Vinod Thakur has explained it in his explanation that really this Vakya came from Srila Damodara and Dharam. And anyhow, how Srila Damodara and Raya Ramana inspired Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur. If Bhakti Vinod had not written the explanation of that is called Sanmodan Bhashya, that it was so hard that we could do it. We are lucky to hear very little. We will explain these things from beginning, and after that we will explain Upadeshamrita and other things. So he is telling Cheto Darpan Marjana. Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur Uttar Devi.
Ingraji Devo? Ingraji?
No. Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur. First is praying like Mangalacharya. Pancha Tattva Anvitam. Nityam pranipatya Mahaprabhu nam nasan modam sikshastas bhasham praniyate Bhagavan Brahma kasnena trir nin anviksh manishaya tata dhashyat kutasthi kutastho ratir atman jato bhana. That now I am going to explain Sanmodan Bhashya. So I am praying my Gurudev. Namo Vishnu Padaya. कृष्ण पृष्ठ गौर पृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमद्भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव अतिमत्तर चरित्राय श्वासिता नाम जपानी में जीव दुखे सदार्थाय नाम प्रिय विदाउट द मर्सी ऑफ गुरुदेव विदाउट द मर्सी ऑफ शिक्षा गुरु लाइक विदाउट द मर्सी ऑफ हाई क्लास ऑफ रियलाइज सोल वी कैनॉट नो ऑल दीज थिंग्स ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड and try to follow. Today I met a devotee and he or she was so hopeless that what should I do? I had no taste in chanting, remembering, hearing the Buddha. I know that a Baddhaji, condition so, it is very hard for him to have a taste in chanting, remembering and hearing Katha. But yet, we'll have to obey Rupa Goswami, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rupa Goswami. He has told, Utsaha, Nishchaya, Dharya, Tattat Karma, Sangat Tyaga, सतो वृत्ति सर्व भक्ति इफ देर इज नो टेस्ट नो हार्म बिकॉज फॉर लैक्स एंड थाउजेंड बर्स वी आर इंजॉइंग दिस वर्ल्ड वी आर कंडीशन सो एनी हाउ लकली इन द एसोसिएशन ऑफ ए नित्योर वैष्णव Now we are understanding that what we are doing wrong. Now we should try to do bhajan of Krishna. We are now realizing. But anyhow, you are so weak. We are. In all respect, we are weak. We are not following all these things. There is no taste and all other things. So many weaknesses are in us. It is true. But I want to do bhajan. So you must not be hopeless. There is no word in hope of hopeless in this dictionary of devotion and love. No? Nothing. Always we should be happy. Jayatma samprasidati. If you are chanting, doing harine, hearing harikatha, it is sure that our Atma will be suprasanna. That is, will be so happy. Automatically, though, if any devotee don't want to be happy, he wants that Krishna should be happy, but yet, automatically happiness will come. Surely it is bound. So, if you are weak, no harm. But we should try to follow Rupa Goswami. Utsaha. Always be enthusiastic. If there is no test even, I will chant and Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Not very slow.
Soft.
No. If something is coming in mind, then Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare, Hare,
Hare Rama.
Louder and louder.
So that these thoughts should not come. Hopeless should not come. And if you will do very lazy in way, very what? In mind. Then they will come. And they will make you hopeless. Don't be hopeless. Like Prahlada. I want to do. Like Prahlad Maharaj, like Haridas Thakur. If prostitute is turned, if Jagai Madhai are turned, why are you not? So Utsaha, Nishya. What is the meaning of Nishya? Shaurya identity. Krishna. Dharya, if there is no taste in name, something wrong is coming in the heart. Don't be
hopeless.
Chant more, fear more. Read the authentic books, Srimad Bhagavatam, Gita, Chaitanya Charitamrita. Dharya, if it is some delay, no hope. No hope. If Hiranyakashipu had done austerities so hard for how many
years? 6,000 years.
60. I know that Valmiki Rishi had that chanted Mara 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 Ram Ram. For how many years?
60,000 years.
And then he drifted the Ram, Ram Shla, Ram Shandish. And he became so. And we want that in a moment we should be. It is not a Rasgulla of Calcutta.
Indian Rasgulla.
Indian Rasgulla. So don't be hopeless. Surely by this method, if you adopt, surely it will come. Because lakhs and lakhs devotees have done in this same path. And I have decided to go with same path. If you will run, but shutting your eyes and jumping in, even there is no
chance of falling down.
In Srimad Bhagavatam it has been written. This path is so easy, made more good than American streets or England's streets or France. There may be any feet in the street, but here in this, nothing.
So
you can run by
closing your eyes,
so jumping anyhow. Oh, there is no fear of falling. So why we should be so weak? Nishya dharya tat tat karma parvartana. But Krishna, I will attend this thing, so I should be sleeping, lazy, being lazy. No. Tat tat karma parvartana. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Svaranam, Pada Sevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Darshanam, Sakham, Atmanivedanam. But in the guidance of any pure, bona fide Vaishnava. And in Vrindavan. But if not Vrindavan, then by mind we will be in Vrindavan always. No harm. We can be in Vrindavan. Anywhere in the part of the world, we can be there. Our body is there, but mind, Krishna has arranged so luckily everything that we can be in Vrindavan. I think that to be in Vrindavan by mind is more superior than being by body there. Because mind is so strong, powerful than this body. And to be with Atma is so more. So this is the path. So we should, especially you should try to do 4-5 things. Sadhu Sangha, Naam Kirtan, Bhagavat Shraman, Vrindavan Mathura, Navadeep Puri Bas. And Shraddha Purvak Archa. 5. Sadhu Sangha, Naam Kirtan, Bhagavat Shraman, Mathura Basi Mukti Shraddha. 5. If you are doing, maintaining all these things, very little, but not doing any offense. Very quickly. In this priority time, at once you will have. At once means in this life you may achieve this goal of the life. So, tat-tat karma prava, sadhu sangha, but all these four should be under the guidance of sadhu sangha always. In sadhu sangha nam kirtan, in sadhu sangha Vrindavan vas, in sadhu sangha
Bhagavat
Sravan, in sadhu sangha archan, everything.
Sadhu sangha common to all.
Common to all. Without sadhu sangha, not so easily fruitful. In this parikrama, we are trying to follow our five things here. Being in Vrindavan, always in sadhu sangha, always Bhagavat sangha, always Sri Mukti, everything is here. So we are lucky. Especially in the heart of Vrindavan, we are here. We will go to Radhakrishna and all other places. So, tat-tat karma pravartanam, sangatyagas. Why it has been given in the end? Why not in the beginning? You should do bhakti. All these things. But it is so essential to give up bad association. What they become, Maharaj told for 1 hour or more than 1 hour. Repeatedly he told. But we are so much more than him. We are stronger. We can defeat him. He should tell whole day, whole life, but we are also so strong that we will not fall. Don't be like this. Don't try to defeat him. Try to...
Defeated by him.
Try to be defeated by him. Daily, he is so merciful that you don't want to listen to him. But yet, he is so having no lajja at all. Repeatedly he reminds us. And it is essential. So, it has been told. Sangatyaga. You should try to give up bad aspirations of Mayavad, Sajya, Sakhi, Bheki, and
materialistic person,
smarts, and self-enjoyer. You should try to be. And most one thing, sixth, tat-tat karma pravartana. Tat-tat na. Sato-vritti. What is the meaning of sato-vritti? What our deceptive lines, guru, acharyas have done to maintain their lives, we should try only to do that. If you are not following, you are bound to follow. How Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Jeev Goswami, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, after that Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, Vrindavan Das Thakur, after that Vishwanath Chakravarti, Raghunath Narottam Thakur, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Baldev Vidyabhushan, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur, especially he is more kind. And then Prabhupada more kind. Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta. And we think, for us, our Gurudev is more kind. Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Srila Prabhupada could not took our this and could not bring. And for you, Swamiji is more, Bhakti Vedanta Swami is more kind. Have so much strong faith on him. He has brought us. So we should try to follow how they maintain their life and we should try to adopt. Otherwise we can do all this. So don't be hopeless in any way. I heard that Kirtika Maharaj was telling me that Parvata पर्वत ऋषि
अंगिरा
अंगिरा अंगिरा महाराज ऋषि वाज सो मर्सीफुल ही गेव हिज सन टू चित्रकेतु महाराज एंड आफ्टर 5 years एंड द सन वाज डेड He was merciful or unmerciful? We think that, oh, he took his son after 5 years. But from beginning he was knowing, he was a realized soul and so merciful. And he wanted that I will give him son and he should die. And then I will go and give this actual truth. And he did so. So they are so powerful. So our Gurudev is also so merciful to us. You should try to thank your Gurudev like that. And try to follow all these things. And then we will begin Sanmodan Harsha. From tomorrow, just about 5, you should be here.
4:30
to 4. Yes. And then 1 hour I will speak on this. And Pujyapad Tribhikam Maharaj from Srimad Bhagavat 11th canto or Chaitanya Chaitanya or other Vaishnava. I Bangla mein bhi kuch Bangla to bolbo. Kintu era bahut tyag kare diye ese che. Eder ke kuch dite. কিন্তু শর্ত এইটা থাকবে ওনলি দ্যার উইল বি এ কন্ডিশন এন্ড দ্যাট কন্ডিশন উইল বি দ্যাট ইউ উইল হ্যাভ ইউ উইল জাস্ট ট্রাই টু টেক ইট হোয়াট উই আর টেলিং উই শুড অল আওয়ার সেলফ অলসো ইউ শুড অলসো ট্রাই টু ফলো আদারওয়াইজ নো অ্যাকশন ট্রাই টু ফলো অ্যাজ পসিবল অ্যাজ ইউ But you should try it. And then, in a moment, you can realize all these things. So, today now, Aarti will be done. And I think if there is any problem for taking prasadam, it is delay for you at 9. And if you will tell them just after Aarti, You can sit and take prasad. We can arrange like this. So you can tell us. There should be no problem for you. And in cooking, if any problem, you can do separately something and you can advise us how we can arrange. Because they are accustomed to cook like Bengali devotees. So you should try to tell and we will try to do like that. Any problem, you should tell us. But one thing I will pray you that you should enlist your names in their register anyhow. Because tomorrow I want that we should decide that how many devotees are with us, they will go to Parikrama. You will have to give the list to Baswala. Otherwise, no permission. So, if you have not registered your name, anyhow today, you can go and register your name. And you should give them what?
Card.
Card. And you should all have card, so that we can manage. বাঙালি যারা ভক্তরা আছে যারা এসেছে পরিক্রমা তারাও সবগুলি নাম লিখে দেবে যাতে কালকে আমরা বাসওয়ালাকে লিস্ট দিব যাতে আমরা কত লোক অ্যাকচুয়ালি আছি নাই তো অসুবিধা হবে একটা কীর্তন কর এনিথিং টু ইউ Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Namami Nandanam, 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 Thank you. Thank you. I'm going to go to the hospital.
Ramchandra Prabhu, can you very brief, can you explain in English what the Vikramar has told, main points?
No?
Krishna Kant.
Krishna Prabhu can.
Navin can tell in brief what he told. Have you heard? Main points. What it all? Main points. Are you are to you chilona? Mike chilona? Main points, man.
Mr.
Parvan, I come after my.
Hare Krishna. Srila Mahayogananda could translate the Vikramar Maharaj's lecture, but in brief, not in detail. So I shall try at my best to express my idea in short form. For Pujya Vasudhi Vikram Maharaj showed that Kudevala is bestowing his mercy. Who can accept his mercy? Gurupad Bhattam and Shastra, that both are merciful and neutral. Sometimes we think our Gurudev loves him so much, bestow his mercy on him, but not for me. But it is not correct. Shastra, scriptures, and Gurupad Bhattam, they are bestowing mercy equally for all. But for accepting that mercy, we have to be qualified. That Gurudev is more merciful than scriptures. If we do any wrong, scriptures will not rectify me. But Shastra scriptures, but Guru Bhagavatam will rectify me that this is wrong and this is right. And Prabhupada Vasudeva Prabhupada explained here that our four ashramas, Grihastha ashram is not best or not better. It is camp from Bhagavan's thai. Srila Maharaj expresses idea about Jaganna. Not Jaganna, it is called Jagandes. Who came here?
Grihastha ashram is so hard.
After that, Paramahansa Yogananda made reconciliation of this point that this ashram is not so high because Givamitra Givamasi Sutra Kanena Jai Krishna Bhakta Vetva Sai Guru Hoy. Who may be in any ashram, if they do bhajan of Krishna, they are qualified and they are so high. So it is not dependent on ashram, it is dependent on quality and qualification. May be any ashram, who may be. Dini Murda Bhaka, who came here to taste the Palmar mood? Srila Tirupram Maharaj, Abuja Tirupram Maharaj explained that Satyavata Muni, he has got Palmar mood. So at first start Namami Saram. But if you will do Namami Saram, if you will do Palmar mood, why is doing Namami? Srila Maharaj give example that in Braj, Sakhas are quarreling with Krishna. Oh Krishna, you are not better than me. Yourself and I myself is equal. And gopis, they are always abusing Krishna. So Krishna told the himself, Rajapura, Garitranam, Parushabacha, Tatha Pramodayati, Sutivati Mahamrinam, Mudra Padada, Vinasake, Tatha. If anyone praying Krishna in sweet words, but in Brajavasis, who loves Krishna's paramatma, if they abuse Krishna, it is more sweeter than sweet prayer of Brahma and others. So here, the paramount mood is best, but we came here to test all these things, but it also depends on our qualification. In Gopis, the Devarata Namami, this word. So, Pujavata Srila Maharaj is giving two examples. That when Krishna gives darshan to Muchikunda Maharaj in cave, Muchikunda was seeing his softness and smoothness of his soul. He became astonished. Oh Krishna, how you came so long way, so many parables taught? He became astonished. But in other hand, when you got this soft Krishna's lotus feet, then you have become astonished. The serving mood is so high. They want to serve Krishna as much as possible. They serve Krishna lotus feet, they love Krishna lotus feet more than their heart and soul. So they are not one soul. Jatne Sriyad Charanam Purnam Spaniyesu Dhita Samayim Yadadumi Karkasesu Tena Kramarasi Dapkata Deina Kingsi Kurpa Devi Dibhavata Ayushana. So my explanation is very short, so I want explanation of this point. Kurpa Devi Kramarasi told that when we will be qualified, then we shall utter and we shall pray like not under guidance of Lord Kuntha Kuru and our Guru Parampara, Gathiya Malati Mala Adivadu Vardale. We shall make garland of Malati flower and offer to divine couple. But this time has not come for us. Us means not for all. Who is qualified that can do? Mahaprabhu came to taste something and to distribute something. Premras Vilkas Kalityas Sadam Ragmata Bhakti Loki Kalitya Prajagam. Mahaprabhu came to taste the mood of Srimati Radha Kudani. Why Krishna came in Mahaprabhu's form to fulfill his three desires? These three desires are to distribute for all, only Ragmata Bhakti. How can achieve Ragmata? Just like Srila Bhujivar Maharaj, Padetaman Swam, Mallaka Masali Niram, Nalavagas Trinam, Smaro Murtinam. Everyone saw Krishna in the mid-assembly of concert. But according to their quality, different person seeing Krishna, saw Krishna in different mood. So Guru Bhagavatam and scriptures, they are just going to mercy clearly, who is qualified according to their qualification. Everyone will accept Buddha's mercy and scriptures' mercy and bhajan
I think it will be better that I should explain in Bengali and Ramchandra little. Otherwise, my mood will be hampered. किंतु बांग्ला में बोलूँगा सब सर्वप्रथम हमारे बुझा उचित जो कृष्ण लीला दो प्रकार भगवान
इज एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट पास्ट टाइम ऑफ कृष्णा इज ऑफ टू काइंड वन इज का pastimes with opulence, that is Aishwaryamayi pastimes. And one is called sweet pastimes, that is Madhurya Leela. Now Maharaj is explaining that what is pastimes in opulence, that is Aishwaryamayi Leela. All those pastimes which transcends the human type of activities, which are beyond the capacity of human and even demigods, they are called pastimes in opulence. And Madhurimayi Leela, sweet pastimes, they are those pastimes where Krishna is performing his pastimes like human being. His all activities are as normal human relationship. Maharaj is explaining that Krishna killed Putana. Putana was
a big... I am not telling that whether it is as well opulence or not, you should tell.
When Krishna is performing his pastimes in Madhurya way, at that time, whether opulence is there or not, it does not matter. His all pastimes are like human being. When he killed Putana, Maharaj is explaining very minutely, it appears that it is a pastime of big opulence because he is killing Putana. But he remained like a very small child. He did not become a huge person to kill Putana. Similarly, when he lifted Govardhan Hill, at that time also, though he lifted such a huge mountain, but his age was only 7 years at that time. Maharaj was explaining also that when the worshipping of Govardhan was taking place, at that time, Govardhan Maharaj, he took huge form, though he was also Krishna. But the person who is worshipping to Govardhan, he was of the same tiny age. The all pastimes which Krishna performs in Braj, Maharaj is explaining, they are pastimes of Madhurya right from the very beginning. Here opulence is also present in the highest extent, more than opulence found in Vaikuntha also. But we see that Krishna's human-like pastimes are there continued. Maharaj explained that when Krishna incarnates, his all incarnations, they perform opulence. But Krishna in Braj, he performs pastimes in Madhurya Leela.
Krishna anugraha जगत ये रूप है ये अन्य कोनों लीला है ये समस्त लीला के प्रकाश ये रूप में माधुर्य में लीला के लिए प्रकाश एक लीला को लेकर श्रवण करे तादर इतना संस्कार है एक लोग सारा जीवन ऐश्वर्य में लीला पैकुंठ में लीला अन्य जिद्दी श्रवण करे
So Maharaj is resolving here a big dispute. He is saying that All those sweet pastimes, which is called Madhurya Leela, which Krishna is performing here, this is his special benevolence and special mercy on the living entities. Suppose if a person is always hearing the pastimes of opulence, that is surely my pastimes, what will be his fate? What will be his attainment? Not more than that. But when Krishna is performing his pastimes of Madhurya here, and we hear such pastimes, hearing such pastimes, because Krishna performs such pastimes here, the person who hears it became capable to enter in such type of pastimes. So Maharaj is explaining, when we hear such type of pastimes carefully, attentively, a greed comes, and that is the capability and eligibility to enter in such pastimes. What is the qualification? He is here referring to Bil Mangal Thakur. Bil Mangal Thakur was attached to a lady. What was his qualification? Apparently there was no qualification. But when one has got some sanskar in him, because he has heard such sweet pastimes of Krishna, then a greed comes in him. Otherwise, there is no hope. Maharaj is explaining very nicely, and it is a wonderful quotation. When a person to the extent of bad character attached to woman, but listen sweet pastimes of Krishna, he generates such high qualification that he transcends the qualification of Hanuman, who is Bal Brahmachari, means who is celebrated from his childhood. If we see closely, the qualification of Hanuman is far more than a person who is attached to girl and woman, because he is celibate from his childhood. But after hearing sweet pastime of Krishna, he became eligible enough to enter into such pastimes of Krishna, and that way he transcends the good fortune of Hanuman, Narad, and up to Uddhava. So the real qualification is that we generate greed, and this greed is, Maharaj is explaining, generated in the heart of those persons who listen such pastimes from qualified Vaishnava. And then he becomes automatically qualified enough to enter in this sweet pastimes. So Maharaj is explaining here, giving so many pastimes, small pastimes in Vatsalyaras, that what is really Madhurya Leela, pastimes of Krishna in sweetness. Maharaj is explaining that Krishna is the ultimate of Godheadness. In this it includes all opulences and all sweetness. He is the ultimate limit of it. When he performs any pastimes in opulence, that is also extreme, and when he is performing any pastimes in sweetness, that is also ultimate. So here in Braj, Krishna is very, very young boy, rather child, new, so beautiful, so loving and charming, and above all, Yashoda Ma decorates him like anything. She puts
ankle bell
on his feet, just one feather of peacock. She insults in his hair, and he becomes so lovely, so charming. It does not look like that he is supreme personality of Godhead. He is a very, very loving child. What type of child? He goes in different houses and steals butter. God will never do it. He is not performing opulent type of pastimes as if a God is performing. Just like a child. He goes in different houses. Why he goes? He goes and performs so many sweet pastimes, and then all those gopis come back to Yashodama. And they narrate, apparently complaining that your child is doing this thing, he is stealing from my house. But in real sense, they are narrating the pastimes of those pastimes of Krishna which he is performing in their house to tell them to Yashodama. And that way Yashodama is listening. I think Maharaj means to say it is Shravanam and Kirtanam. So when Krishna goes, Maharaj is explaining here 5-6 pastimes, and very fast I am narrating you. Yashoda Maharaj is there, a gopi comes and complains, look what your child is doing. He came to my house with his so many friends, then he instigated my child. Then go and open the robe of the calf of and make it free, so that no sooner calf is made free, he will run to his mother and will drink the milk. So he will go and open the robe of the calf, and then he will say to my own son, go and ask your mother that calf has been is free and he has gone to the cow and drinking milk. Then he cries, Mama, this calf has run to drink the milk. And Ma, the mother of that boy, she will leave churning the butter and she will go to catch hold of that calf. Meanwhile, she enters into their house and will eat all the butter. So this way he is doing stealing in my house. Another place, Krishna enters into house, there is dark. House is full of darkness, but as soon as Krishna enters, light comes there. Though, from where the light is coming? Now Maharaj is saying, from the jewels he is wearing, the light is emanating from that jewels. And there is light in that house, and Gopi, she just catches him. Oh, you have come to steal butter. He says, no, I have come to eat butter. I think you love me very much, and when I will eat butter, you will be happy because you love me. And he is speaking such sweetly that she gets so much attached, and she was catching hold of him, then she leaves him. Similarly, one gopi, she has just hung the butter with a bell. The moment Krishna will take butter from it, that bell will ring. And then Krishna is playing what type of pastimes? That he is making all his friends to bow down to make a stair. And then he will climb there on the shoulder of his friends and catch hold of that bell and will take all butter and will eat and will go away. And bell will not ring. Another house he enters, there is darkness. Gopi catches him. Krishna, you came to my house to steal? Oh, sorry. I thought it is my house. There he is saying, oh, I thought it is my house. Then Maharaj is explaining, at one time Gopi catch hold of Krishna's hand and says, today I will take you to, it is dark in her house, today I will take you to Yashodama and will tell that here is the evidence that Krishna, you have stolen the butter. And very cunningly, Krishna exchanges his hand with the hand of her own son. And this lady who is having veil, you know veil, Mungat, she goes there, today I will take you to Yashoda. Oh Yashoda, come here, here I have caught him red-handed. And you will see that how your child is notorious and stealing my butter. Where is my child? Where is my child? Yashoda says, here is your... Oh, but this is not Krishna. Here is the child of her own. Oh, it is your son. And meanwhile, Krishna is coming from inside the house, just like doing this, as if he was sleeping. Oh, mother, oh, mother. So mother says that she has come to complain. Yes, yes, they are just doing false complaint of mine. You see the evidence. And this way, Krishna is proving that all these gopis are telling a lie. Another time, he will go and he was caught red-handed while his hand was inside the pitcher. He will say, gopi will ask, you are stealing? No, 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 I was not stealing. In fact, my calf entered into the pitcher. Calf? Can calf enter into the pitcher? Yes, yes, yes. Where is calf? Then he will just take out a toy calf from the pitcher. Here is my calf, that was in pitcher. Another time, he will put his hand inside the pitcher and was caught. He said, gopi said, you are eating butter? No, 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 I was not eating butter. My mother had put so much jewels on my hand that my hands were burning. So I was finding how to keep the cool it. So I found this pitcher was full of butter and matha. So I put my hand into it. And how this butter is on your mouth? Oh, these friends have done it. I have not done it. So Maharaj is saying so many pastimes, absolutely like a child. There is no any symbol that he is God. They are called Madhuri pastimes.
But if you how do how the gopis complain to Mother Yashoda? Seeming to not explain at all.
Krishna kakhono jhuth bolen nai, mithya bolen nai. যদি কোনো একজন বিরাট ধনী ব্যক্তি রাজা কোন বিরাট ধন সম্পত্তি অথবা মণি মুক্তা সব রেখেছে আর একটা চুরি করবার মতন একটা অভিনয় করেন তার ছেলের কাছে তার স্ত্রীর কাছে কি অন্য লোকের কাছে তাহলে সেটি কি চুরি হবে কৃষ্ণ তো অফিস জগতে
So, after the sweet pastime, Maharaj is coming to the principles and siddhant. If we see Krishna is stealing and telling a lie, then Krishna, who is Supreme Personality of Godhead, he is committing mistake and he is faulty because he is telling a lie. And he is stealing. So, it's not good. So Maharaj is explaining, in fact, suppose if a king who has everything in his own house, he plays a role, he does a drama, or he does an activity where he is stealing something from his child or from his wife, will it be called that he is a thief? A very rich man, a very wealthy man, if he is stealing something in his own house, he is not a thief. It is his drama, it is his role, it is his... So these are the pastimes of Krishna. Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. Everything belongs to him. All gopis are his potency. There is nothing separate from him. So if he goes in the house of gopis and steal butter, he is not stealing. Because in fact, stealing, when you put a charge and allegation on someone, stealing is when it belongs to someone else. If a thing belongs to himself and he takes it away, it is not stealing. So Krishna is going to the houses of different gopis and stealing butter. He is not stealing butter, he is stealing the heart of those gopis. This butter symbolizes heart of gopis. Maharaj is explaining. So Krishna is hence stealing everything of everyone. He is so much potent. Everything belongs to him. Similarly, all gopis with whom he is performing ras and all, they are his potency, Krishna's potency. So his pastime with those gopis is not illicit activity. All these gopis are playing a role as if they belong to someone else. That is called Parikyapa. In order to test this mood, such circumstances have been created as if these gopis belong to someone else and Krishna is performing pastimes with them. But the truth lies that all gopis are his own potency. When Parikshit Maharaj saw that so many people who are unable to understand that this thing, he asked the question to Shukdev Goswami. Shukdev Goswami was in very, very sweet mood to narrate all these pastimes of Krishna, Ras Leela. But when Parikshit Maharaj asked, how come Krishna is playing and dancing with the wives of others? Is it not illicit activity? He is asking them to remove the doubts of those people who are not able to understand. And Shukdev Goswami, he nearly scolded him. He said, oh, look, I have already told you. What you have already told me? I have already told you that if anyone attaches himself with Krishna, he may does it by enviousness. Anyone who starts thinking about Krishna, maybe by anger, he attains Krishna. I have already told you and given you examples of Shishupal and Kans. So if anyone who is loving Krishna, maybe by lust, can't she attain Krishna? Gopi's lust is not ordinary lust of human life. So we should understand that everything which is being performed past time here in Krishna is supreme. In fact, those who are oriented towards rules and regulations and opulence, it is difficult for them to understand. They generally keep on hearing the pastimes of Ram and all. We saw, like Venkat Bhat, he was worshipping Lakshmi Narayan, every time listening the pastime of Lakshmi Narayan, and he was attached with the rules, regulation and opulence. But when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went there, he had a very long discussion, and by his mercy, he inculcated the Madhurya mood in him, and then he understood that real pastimes of Krishna is sweet and up and above mood of opulence.
Now you should be ready in only 5 minutes. Harshananda Prabhu and Subhananda, they will take you to first Seva Kunja. Seva Kunja, you please tell us.
Brother Dabla.
Mother Kupina.
And anything. Mother must then stay young. Because Ram has given order that you can look here and there. Because I never gave you at that time. So you are free to take anything. So you should not be disturbed. Sometimes then take your glasses and anything, your bags with money and passport. And then you will have to give something for the time. So we
of this year. Go, Brahma. Hare Krishna.
Thank you. সঙ্গে সঙ্গে বাঁশিটি টেনে নিয়েছেন। নিয়ে এখন পিছন দিকে করেছেন এমন সময় রূপমঞ্জরি নিয়ে নিলেন, নিয়ে সঙ্গে সঙ্গে রতি মঞ্জরিকে এইভাবে করতে করতে অনেক গুণী রাগরানীর কথাগুলি শোনাবে আর আমাদের বিরহের কথাগুলি শোনাবে। আর যে আমরা তাহার বিরহ সহ্য করতে পারছি, কিন্তু আমরা কি করবো, আমাদের ভাগ্য খারাপ, আমাদের কপাল খারাপ কি মা যশোদা কৃষ্ণকে লালন পালন করে আজকে যে সে চলে গেছে কাকের বাসায় রেখে আসে আর কাকের ডিমটা ফেলে দেয়। সেই কোকিল কাক এখন মনে করে নিজের ডিম, এখন তার উপরে বসতে বসতে ধীরে ধীরে যখন তাহার থেকে সেই ডিম ফুটে বাচ্চা বের হয়, বাচ্চা হয় তখন মনে করে বাহ খুব সুন্দর বালক হয়েছে তো বাচ্চা হয়েছে, তখন তাহাকে লালন পালন করতে থাকে। যখন বড় হয়ে যায় পাখা উঠে যায় যখন উড়তে শিখে গেছে, এমন সময় কোকিল গাছের ডালে বসে বসে দূরে এখন কুহু কুহু আওয়াজ করতে থাকে, তাহার আওয়াজ শুনে তখন কোকিলের বাচ্চা তখন উড়ে চলে যায় আর থাকে না, আর কাক তখন হাঁ করে দেখতে থাকে এ কি হলো আমার শিশু কেন চলে গেল, তখন সে অবাক হয়ে কাঁপতে থাকে। তো এইরকম যশোদার পুত্রে জেনে আমরা তো তাহাকে লালন পালন করেছি, আমরা তাহার সঙ্গে প্রীতি করেছি, আজকে যে সে এইভাবে
রাধা কৃষ্ণ লীলা কৃষ্ণের হরিষ্ঠ লীলা ডান হিয়ার কৃষ্ণ আরাধ্যতে এটি রাধা, অর্থাৎ এই হিয়ার কৃষ্ণ আশিস রাধা, নট রাধা আশিস কৃষ্ণ, যে কৃষ্ণ আশিস রাধা সদের সো দি প্লেস ইজ কল সেবাকুঞ্জ। কৃষ্ণ গিফ্টস ফ্লাওয়ার টু দি ফিট অফ দি রাধা হিয়ার টু আশিস কৃষ্ণ ইভিনিং হাফ ফেয়ার রাধা সেজ দে শি উইল নট সি ব্ল্যাক থিংস বিকজ কৃষ্ণ ইজ ভেরি ব্ল্যাক। কৃষ্ণ হিমসেলফ ড্রোজ পিকচার্স ইন দি হার্ট অফ দি রাধা, কৃষ্ণ হিমসেলফ ড্রোজ পিকচার্স ইন দি হার্ট অফ রাধা, রাধা প্লেস আশা খেলা স্কুল আশা খেলা উইথ কৃষ্ণ ডাইস কৃষ্ণ প্লেস ডাইস উইথ কৃষ্ণ রাধা প্লেস ডাইস উইথ কৃষ্ণ হিয়ার ওয়াইন কৃষ্ণ ডিফিটেড রাধা স্টোলেন হিস বাসি হিয়ার বাসি ফ্লুট ইয়েস ওয়াইন কৃষ্ণ ডিফিটেড বাই রাধা দেন কৃষ্ণ রাধা স্টোলেন স্টোল হিস ফ্লুট ইয়ার অ্যান্ড কৃষ্ণ বিগিন টু ক্রাই অ্যান্ড আদার গোপি সেস দে ডোন্ট ক্রাই দ্যার নো এই হিয়ার বেম্বু হিয়ার ইউল বি এবল টু হ্যাভ অ্যানাদার বেম্বু অ্যানাদার ফ্রুট হিয়ার রূপগোস্বামী সেস দে রাধা গেট হাফ ফেল হিয়ার অ্যান্ড গোপিস বিগিন টু ক্রাই হ্যান্স রাধাংশ হিজ কাম হিয়ার অ্যান্ড গোপিস সেন্স টু সেন রাধাংশ টু মথুরা সো দ্যাট কৃষ্ণ উইল বি স্যাটিসফাইড হিয়ার। ওকে হরে কৃষ্ণ।
ॐ ज्ञान सिमरन् जन शलाकिया चक्षुर्न मिलतम येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। सो
बांदी रहे जैसे बात
फर्स्ट आई विल लाइक टू मेक ए कंप्लीट समरी स्टेटमेंट अबाउट शुभन एंड प्रभुज लेक्चर आई थिंक which you might have not understood completely, so your attention is required. He was saying that this place is important because here Krishna is serving Radharani. So it is called Seva Kunj. The topmost importance of this place is that one who is called devotee, he became a receiver of the service, and one who is God, he became the server. So apparently the streamline, the stream, what is the system, it goes from higher to the lower, but here the stream is going from lower to higher. When Radharani saw this place, Krishna has left to Mathura and she is totally in the mood of separation, acute separation, and she happened to come nearby and saw this place. The moment she sees this place, all the pastimes performed by them, yeah, them means by Radha and Krishna, they became so much explicit in her heart. She started remembering all those pastimes in the chain form and she became faint. At that time, there is a book written by Srila Rupa Goswami, probably his name is Hansdut. Hansdut ka suna rahe the aap kisa? Basically, he said that it was mentioning in of Ujjwal Nilmani also. At that time, one of the friends of Sakhi of Radharani, she saw Swan. She saw Swan in Yamuna and she is telling Swan, please go to Mathura and tell everything to Krishna. Krishna will be there in Mathura, but he will also be absorbed in thought of Braj, Vrindavan, lying on his cot, putting his head on his hand, and then you tell what is happening here. A very pathetic scene he has just narrated, if at all we can realize it. You know what happens? That crow has got its nest, and cuckoo bird there lays its egg in the nest of crow. She does not make her nest. Then crow thinks that it is my egg. Then she cares for that egg, hatches that egg. A very, very young infant comes. That crow brings up that child of crow. And when it starts growing up and up, crow feeds. Every day she feeds. She has got so deep attachment with this child, her son. But when she grows, this child grows up, instead of saying crows, cow, it starts saying cuckoos, cuckoo. And it starts flying, and then it flies away and goes in the group of cuckoos, and crow keeps on saying, oh, what happened? It was my child, what happened to her? Similarly, Krishna was child of Devaki, we came to know now, but was brought up by Yashoda Ma. Every day she was giving her milk to him. She was having such a deep attachment for him. And one day when he grew up and he ran away, he flew away and went to his own place. So this is the condition of Brijvasis and Yashoda. Very pathetic scene. But these gopis, those who are deep in separation mode, they are thinking like this. But fact is not this. Krishna is always son of Yashoda. The fact is this. Then Rasanand Prabhu, he came up with a very nice narration. He said, we have come to Seva Kunj. Why it is so important? Its importance is because we see that all the scriptures and all the highly saints like Brahma, Narada and all. They worship Krishna. They worship lotus feet of Krishna. They try to meditate upon lotus feet of Krishna, and it is difficult for them to catch hold of Krishna's feet in their meditation. To such Krishna, of whose feet are difficult for Narada and Brahma, a rasik bhakt, one who is devotee, he says, when I will have his darshan. A devotee of Braj, a rasik bhakt, has desire to see Krishna. The same Krishna whose lotus feet are not attainable in the meditation of big sages. So, when he asks, how can I have darshan of Krishna? Then someone says, you go to Vrindavan. And in Vrindavan, there is a place named Sevakunj. You go to Sevakunj. Oh, I will have his darshan. In what form he will be there? I want to know. He is already getting the information. If you will go to there, you will find Krishna there with Radharani, and he will be massaging feet of Radharani. In this form, you will see darshan of Krishna if you go to Sevakunj. So this is the highest position of this place where Krishna is massaging the feet of Radha Krishna, Radharani. And Jayadev Goswami has said that Krishna is begging to Radharani, please give up your man. Give up your this anger mood. I request on your lotus feet. Krishna is saying, what do you request? That please put your feet on my head. This is his desire. So, where Krishna is extending such desire to Radharani, and Radharani is fulfilling his desire, this is the place which is called Sevakunj. Krishna is so much merciful on those people who are saying Radha Radha. This is the place people don't chant the name of Krishna. Any person who just speaks Radha and opens his mouth and says Ra, Krishna becomes worried that what should I give to him. He has just uttered one part of my beloved's name, Ra, what should I give to him? He became ready and desirous to give anything for him. At the same time, when he says Dha, then Krishna becomes totally flat. He just started running after that person. That when he was saying Ra, I was ready to give him everything. Now he has said Radha, so I am ready to give myself also to him. So this is the importance of the name Radha. This place is called Nikunj also. Nikunj means where? Nibhrit Kunj. The place of solitude. Solicitude. Kya kya? Solitude. Lonely place. Very, 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 very open world, lonely place. Where there is no hindrance and interruption and problems. This is the lonely place. Here, Vrinda Devi has created such a nice kunj. He is saying that what type of kunj is? Floor is vacant. And such a nice trees are arranged in a way, creepers and tree, so densely that if it rains, not a single drop of water will come. We make our house and find that it leaks, but this kunj does not leak because of rain water. Water does not come, what about sun? He says, not what to speak of water, even a ray of sun does not come inside. It is so dense and it is so protected, and coolness is there. In such kunj, Radharani takes to Krishna and fulfills the desire of Krishna. The important point is that all those gopis who are Radharani's friend, they only can come here. Even Lalita and all, they are called praised Sakhi, they also can't enter here. So why we have come here? We have come to pray at the lotus feet of Radha and Krishna, all the sakis. These trees, they are very, very exalted sages. They are performing their austerities and bhajan here. And they are seeing the pastime of Krishna and Radharani here. And they wanted to have their mercy. So we should pray at their lotus feet so that they should bestow our mercy. Because Naraji has obtained a benediction from Krishna that whenever any person goes to the places where you have performed the pastimes and touches the dust of that place, then the dust of that place will give you, give that person opportunity that pastimes will reveal in the heart. So I will ask Naraji that where is this benediction? We are touching the feet, the dust so many years, but still the pastime is not revealed in my heart. So is the benediction not okay? Benediction may be okay, but my heart is not okay. Gaur Premanande.
Achirigat esnaan etul tolate ashi korila avishram Vrindavane madde one prachine vrikho pa bhagavan ne লীলাকালীন বহু বৃক্ষাদি অন্যান্য স্মৃতি বিরাজমান রয়েছেন। তবে বৃক্ষগণের মধ্যে আমরা কালীদহতে কেলি কদম্ব এবং ইমলি দলায় এই তেঁতুল বৃক্ষের সম্বন্ধে আমরা জানতে পারি এবং এই তেঁতুল বৃক্ষ তাই হলে কৃষ্ণ লীলাকালের। কাজেই আমাদের এই বর্তমানে ইনি যেমন জগন্নাথে কলেবর পরিবর্তন করেন, এখানেও তাঁর এই ইচ্ছায় এই তেঁতুল বৃক্ষ ইনি পুরাতন রূপ পরিত্যাগ করে এখন নূতন রূপে প্রকটিত হয়েছেন এবং এই স্থান গৌড়ী ও বৈষ্ণব সম্প্রদায়ের সর্বশ্রেষ্ঠ স্থান। আমাদের পরমাত্মার সৌভাগ্যের বিষয় আমাদের গুরুদেব মৃত্যুলীলা প্রবিষ্ট জগৎগুরু মুষ্ণুবাদ শ্রীমৎ ভক্তি সারঙ্গ গোস্বামী মহারাজ মথুরায় অম্বরীশ টিলার নিম্নে প্রথমে শ্রী নিত্যানন্দ গৌড়ীয় মঠ প্রতিষ্ঠা করেছিলেন। ভক্তগণের ইচ্ছা আমার সতীর্থ শ্রীপাদ মন বাবা প্রমুখ অনেক ভক্তগণ গুরুদেবকে জানালেন বৃন্দাবনে আমাদের আশ্রমকে হবে না। গুরুদেব বলেছিলেন নিতাই কৃপা হলে তবে বৃন্দাবনে নিশ্চয় হবে। তারপরে এই স্থানে সেবক ছিলেন মদন মোহনের সেবক শ্রী বীরেশ্বর গোস্বামীজি, তিনি ইচ্ছা করেই আমাদের গুরুদেবকে আহ্বান করে এই সেবাটি দিয়েছেন। তা আমাদের কিছু দুর্ভাগ্য যে এখনো আমরা এর সংস্কার কার্য সুষ্ঠুরূপে করতে পারছি না। কিছু কিছু ভক্ত আশ্বাস দিয়েছেন আশা করা যায় এরপরে মন্দির হবে। শ্রী চৈতন্য মহাপ্রভুর এই স্থান যখন লাভ করেন অর্থাৎ মহাপ্রভু এখানে যখন সুবিজয় করেছিলেন বৃন্দাবনের মধ্যে সেবাকুঞ্জ নিধুবন এবং বংশীবট বহু বহু প্রসিদ্ধ স্থান রয়েছে, শ্রীমন মহাপ্রভু কোথায় বসেন নাই, তিনি এইখানেই প্রথমে বসেছিলেন। চৈতন্য চরিতামৃতে উল্লেখ করেছেন প্রাতে বৃন্দাবনে কইলা চিরঘাটে স্নান তেঁতুল তলাতে আসি করিলা বিশ্রাম। এই তেঁতুল তলায় তিনি বিশ্রাম করলেন, কেন বিশ্রাম করেছিলেন না? ভগবান শ্রীকৃষ্ণ যখন এই বৃন্দাবনে মহারাস করছিলেন সেই সময় অনন্ত কোটি গোপীগণ তাদের মধ্যে ভগবান অনন্ত রূপ ধারণ করে ভগবানের সর্বশ্রেষ্ঠ লীলা যে রাস লীলা যখন এই আনন্দময় বৃন্দাবনে মহা আনন্দের বন্যা প্রবাহিত হচ্ছিল ঠিক সেই সময় দেখলেন ভগবান শ্রীকৃষ্ণ সকল গোপীগণের মধ্যে সকল গোপীগণের সঙ্গে ভগবান শ্রীকৃষ্ণ একই প্রকার ব্যবহার করছেন, তাই দেখে শ্রী রাধারানীর অভিমান হল। এই জগতের অভিমানটা হচ্ছে নরকে যাওয়ার রাস্তা, আর এই রাজ্যে বৃন্দাবনের মধ্যে গোপীগণের সেবা গোপগণের সেবা তাদের সমস্ত সেবাই সেটা পর্যবসিত হয় ভক্তিতে। কাজেই তাদের অভিমান এটাও কৃষ্ণের আনন্দ বর্ধনের জন্য। রাধা রানী তার বোন নিয়ে যখন তিনি রাসমন্ডল ছেড়ে চলে যান, তার ললিতা আদি সখীগণকে নিয়ে ভগবান একটু পরেই লক্ষ্য করলেন রাসেশ্বরী শ্রী রাধিকা এখানে নাই। তখন তিনি অন্বেষণ করলেন কোথায় রাধা রানী এলেন, তাই ঘুরতে 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 কোথায় না পেয়ে ভগবান শ্রীকৃষ্ণ এখানে এসে শ্রী রাধা রানীর ভাব চিন্তা করতে করতে, কি ভাব? বিপ্লম্ব ভাব, অবস্তুকে প্রাপ্তির যে বাসনা প্রবল ইচ্ছা তাহাই বিপ্লম্ব নামে কথিত। যাই হোক, সেইভাবে বিবাহিত হয়ে ভগবান শ্রীকৃষ্ণ এখানে বসে শ্রী রাধা রানী সেই বিপ্লম্ব ভাবে প্রভাবিত হয়ে এখানে বসেছিলেন, এবং রাধা রানীর চিন্তা করতে করতে তার শরীরের রঙটি হয়েছিল কৃষ্ণের রঙটি রাধারানীর মতন। তাদের কৃষ্ণের রাধারানীর ভাব এবং কান্তি এই উভয় নিয়ে শ্রীকৃষ্ণ এখানে বসেছিলেন, এবং সেই রাধারানীর ভাব কান্তি যুক্ত কৃষ্ণই এই লীলায় গৌরসুন্দর রূপে যে গৌর রূপ এখানে ধারণ করেছিলেন ব্রজের মধ্যে সেই গৌর লীলা প্রকাশ করলেন শ্রী নবদ্বীপ ধামে, এবং নবদ্বীপ ধাম থেকে যখন তিনি এখানে শুভ বিজয় করেছিলেন অন্য কোথাও না বসে এখানেই বসেছিলেন। কাজেই এই স্থানের গৌড়ীয় বৈষ্ণবগণের সর্বশ্রেষ্ঠ স্থান বলে এটি কথিত। আমাদের পরম সৌভাগ্য, অনেক সময় আমরা যেতে পারি না, কিন্তু সকল বৈষ্ণব গৌড়ীয় বৈষ্ণবগণ বিভিন্ন শ্রেণীর মধ্যেও যাহারা আছেন গৌড়ীয় মঠ ছাড়াও অন্যান্য যে সমস্ত গৌর সুন্দরের আশ্রয় করেছেন এইরকম অভিমান যাহারা করেন তাহারা সকলেই আসেন। শুধু তাই নয়, সমস্ত বাংলাদেশের ভক্তগণ তারা তাদের দর্শনের মধ্যে এই স্থানটি প্রধান রূপে তারা এসে দর্শন করেন। এখানে বিগ্রহগণের মধ্যে হচ্ছেন শ্রী মহাপ্রভুর গৌর নিত্যানন্দ বিগ্রহ, শ্রীমন মহাপ্রভুর প্রকটকালীন আমরা চারটি স্থানে মহাপ্রভুর বিগ্রহ দেখতে পাই। তার মধ্যে নবদ্বীপ কুলদ্বীপের মধ্যে বিষ্ণুপ্রিয়া দেবীর সেবিত বিগ্রহ রয়েছেন, শ্রী গৌর সুন্দর। তারপরে আর সেই নবদ্বীপ মণ্ডলের মধ্যে সেখানে রয়েছেন গৌর গদাধর, মহাপ্রভুর প্রকটকালীন বিগ্রহ। আর তৃতীয় হচ্ছেন কালনায় গৌরীদাস পণ্ডিতের সেবিত বিগ্রহ শ্রী শ্রী গৌর নিত্যানন্দজীব। এই প্রত্যেকটা এছাড়া ব্রজমন্ডলের মধ্যে এই সনাতন গোস্বামী প্রভুর আরাধ্য দেবতা, তিনি এখানটায় এই তার বিগ্রহ প্রকট কি করেছিলেন। আমরা এখানের যে গোস্বামী বা বীরেশ্বর গোস্বামী মহারাজ গোসাইজি, তিনি তার মুখে আমরা এইসব কথা শুনেছি এবং এটা পরম্পরাক্রমে। কাজে মহাপ্রভুর প্রকটকালীন বিগ্রহের মধ্যে ইনি মাঝখানে প্রকোষ্ঠে সেই গৌর নিত্যানন্দ বিরাজমান, বাদিকে শ্রী রাধা গোপীনাথজীব, এবং দক্ষিণে গৌড়ীয় মঠের প্রতিষ্ঠাতা আমাদের পরম গুরুদেব ছিল ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী ঠাকুর, তার গুরুবর্গ বংশ পার্শ্ব তিনি বিরাজমান করছেন। কাজেই এই ইমলিতলা বিভিন্ন দিক থেকে এর শ্রেষ্ঠতা রয়েছে, এবং এখানটায় আমাদের পরম এটা সৌভাগ্যের বিষয়। গুরুদেব সমস্ত ভারতবর্ষ তথা পার্চাত্য প্রদেশে বিশেষভাবে তার গুরুদেবের মন অভীষ্ট পূর্ণার্থে তার ইচ্ছাকে কেন্দ্র করে তার আশীর্বাদকে মস্তকে ধারণ করে এবং তাকে মিশনারি ইনচার্জ এই ভূষণে ভূষিত করে স্বীয় মাল্য অর্পণ করে তাকে পাঠাইছিলেন বিলাতে। বিভিন্ন স্থানে প্রচারের পর ভারতবর্ষে এসে তিনি দেখলেন সতীর্থগণের মধ্যে সরস্বতী ঠাকুর আমাদের পরম গুরুদেব যে প্রচারের আকাঙ্ক্ষা করেছেন তাতে কিছু বাধা হয়েছে, যে কোনো কারণে তখন গুরুদেব তিনি কোথায় আশ্রম করবেন চিন্তা করে সিদ্ধ বাবাজি ছিল বংশীদাস বাবাজি মহারাজ নবদ্বীপ উপলদ্বীপের গঙ্গা তীরে অবস্থান করছিলেন গুরু মহারাজ সেখানে গেলেন কোথায় আশ্রম করবেন এই তার কাছ থেকে একটা নির্দেশ নেওয়ার জন্য তিনি কথাবার্তা বলতেন না বিশেষ গুরুদেব সেখানে প্রণাম করে বসেছেন একটু পরেই তিনি বলে উঠেছেন মথুরা 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 এই পারত্রয় তিনি উচ্চারণ করলেন গুরুদেব তখন বুঝতে পারলেন আমার মথুরাই তাই গৌরীর সঙ্গে মূল আশ্রম আমাদের সেই মথুরায় এবং নিত্যানন্দ গৌরী মঠ নামে যা প্রসিদ্ধ ছিল সেই নিত্যানন্দ প্রভুর কৃপাতেই এই ইমিতলা আর সেবা শ্রী গুরুদেব তিনি লাভ করেছেন গৌর নিত্যানন্দের সেবা এবং রাধা গোপীনাথের আমরাও তার কৃপা অনুগ্রহে এখানে সেই সেবা করতে এখানে বৈষ্ণবগণ আসছেন পরম আনন্দের বিষয় আমাদের খুব ছোট জায়গা এখানটায় সকলের আমরা যথোচিত সম্মান করতে অসমর্থ সেজন্য সমস্ত ভক্তগণের কাছে আমাদের ত্রুটি বিচ্যুতি আপনারা ক্ষমা করবেন যাতে এই স্থানটি আরো প্রসার লাভ করে ভক্তগণের আরো আনন্দের বিষয় হয় আচ্ছা আমি এখানটায় বিদেশের আমাদের অনেক আমাদের মঠে মঠাশ্রিত ভক্তগণ রয়েছেন তাদের সম্বন্ধে এখানের কথা আপনারা আরো বিশেষভাবে কিছু শ্রবণ করবেন জয় শ্রী শ্রী গুরু গৌরাঙ্গ নিত্যানন্দ রাধা বিনোজ্জু জয় যুক্ত নিত্য লীলা প্রবিষ্ট জগদ্গুরু বিষ্ণু শিশুম ভক্তি সার গোস্বামী মহারাজ জয় যুক্ত জয় আমার শিক্ষা গুরু পরম পূজ্য নিত্য লীলা বৃষ্ট শ্রীমদ ভক্তি প্রজ্ঞান কেশব গোস্বামী মহারাজ জয় যুক্ত জয়ামী পরিব্রাজগাচার্য শ্রীমান ভক্তি বেদান্ত বামন মহারাজ জয় যুক্ত হন জয়ামী শ্রীপাদ ভক্তি বেদান্ত নারায়ণ মহারাজ জয় যুক্ত হন আচার্য বৃন্দ বৈষ্ণব বৃন্দ ভক্ত বৃন্দ জয় যুক্ত হন গৌর প্রেম আনন্দে
ओम ज्ञान तिमिर अंधस्य ज्ञान अंजन शलाकिया चक्षुर न मिल तम येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे तो महाराज हैज वेरी विविडली एक्सप्लेन इन बंगला द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ दिस प्लेस If I am not incorrect, the name of present Acharya over here who are presiding this place as well as looking after Imlitala, his name is His Holiness Pujyapad Akinchan Maharaj. It's because we are supposed to know the name of the speaker also. He told that in our Gaudiya Sampradaya, the disciplic succession from which we belong to, this is called Gaudiya Sampradaya. This place is considered to be the topmost place in Vrindavan. Name of this place is Imli Tala. Imli is the name of a tree and its English is, who will tell me? Tamarind. So the Imli means tamarind. The tree which you see behind here, it is tamarind tree. And Tala means base. We are sitting on the base of tamarind tree. So the name of this place is Imli Tala. It is just at the bank of Yamuna ji. Yamuna is flowing quite nearby, you can see. Maharaj told in the scriptures, there are so many descriptions of so many things, but special two trees are mentioned. One is Kadam tree at Kadambasthali Kaliya Daha, and another is this tamarind tree. Though this tree has changed its body so many times, but still the tree is there and giving us stimulant of that time when Krishna performed his pastime here. We learned that Shriman Mahaprabhu came to Vrindavan and he chose among so many places only this place where he took rest. Maharaj told that it is stated in the scripture that he took bath at Chirghat and he took shelter and rest here. What type of rest he took? All the pastime of Krishna recollected in his mind. What type of pastime? In fact, Krishna was performing pastime of Ras Leela. At that time, Radharani became angry, Manani. Why? Because she said, oh, you are dealing all the gopis on the equal platform than me. So, what is my importance? Every time you say that I am more important, I am the most beloved, but right now you are treating me on the same level as you are treating other gopis. Just on this ground, she became Manani, angry. Sulky mood. Yeah. She adopted sulky mood. Anyway, and she left over. She went away from the Ras. The moment Krishna noticed that Radharani is not there and she has left, then he thought, how can Ras Leela be performed? What is the use of Ras Leela? The whole Ras Leela Krishna is performing because of Radharani. And when Radharani herself is not there, then what is the use of Ras Leela? And thinking this, totally in memory of Radharani, Krishna also stopped performing Ras and he left the assembly of all gopis. Krishna is looking for Radharani. He is going here and there, wandering in search of Radharani, and finally he came here. There was a tamarind tree. He said beneath it, that is beneath means the place where he said is tala, imli tala. He was so absorbed in Radharani's thought. He had a very deep and acute feeling of separation for Radharani. And because of this separation feeling and mood and full absorption of Radharani, how much absorption, think? We cannot imagine probably. The absorption was so much that his complexion starts changing. From black he became white complexion. Therefore this place is where Krishna is deeply absorbed in thought of Radharani and gets his complexion changed as the complexion of Radharani, that is golden complexion. Therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came. He is also to some extent the same who is having the complexion of Radharani and mood of Radharani. He sat here and he also absorbed in the same mood. So this is the place. Then Maharaj also told the importance of this place, that his Gurudev, Param Pujyapad Bhakti Sarang Goswami Maharaj, he came here. He got blessing from Bansidas Maharaj there. You told something like this. A blessing to come to Mathura. He also preached all over world, and when he came to Mathura, he said it that establishing our temple in Mathura Vrindavan is pure mercy of Nityananda Prabhu and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Somehow or other he got an opportunity wherein he was offered this place to rejuvenate. It was a totally deserted place. So to renew this place and to give a new life to it, he came, he did once. Our Gurudev also narrated that he really did a lot of labor and he brought this place, as we are seeing now, able to sit, to listen and remember the pastimes of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Krishna. If I am not wrong, once Maharaj told that this tree keeps on changing the body and again new tree is sowed. So once probably Maharaj, our Gurudev also came and he did the same contribution in getting this tree again. We see that the old tree is this and the new tree is coming up. So this is the importance of this place. And where will you go now?
Here, Radha Ji's abhishek.